Good day, folks. In my previous video, I have a video that I explain or introduce vibrating screens for you. I've also created a model that allows you at least to predict sizing screen performance. Now, this model is based on the vibrating screen manufacturer's manual. I've put this in a folder that you can have access to. It is in the mass balance predictor for a hydrocyclone, you know, guidelines for mineral processing, and vibrating screen manufacturer's model. That's just what we're discussing now. The Rosendam curve, and as I said, this model based on the vibrating screen manufacturer's manual. What I need to mention is the vibrating screen manufacturer's model, as I've mentioned in previous video on screens, is actually the basis of vibrating screen manufacture today. A lot of screen suppliers have not, I wouldn't say veered off, but they have put their own enhancements on it. So what this model will give you is a good basis of from which to start and to discuss with your various vendors that could supply you. Now, where you could get the thing is offer.ndme-inc.com, and if you go to the website, you will see it's here. So that by going in here and putting your email address, you would get access to that folder that I've shown you. The benefit of having your email address is just that I can give you updates when they arrive, and just tell you, you know, give you the link and to refresh the getting of that all the data that I've got there. Anyway, back to the model. Let's just discuss that. Here it is. So as you can see, this model is based on vibrating screen manufacturer's model, and the way this model worked is I adopted it from the LIM simulation software. And basically, as I've mentioned previously, LIM is an Excel add-in. So all the models in LIM are actually Excel based, and you can look at them. And so that's why I was able to build this up in conjunction with the vibrating screen manufacturer's manual. But how this model works is just as a default in terms of formats is the blue is where you can put details in. And then you can just choose if you have a PSD, then you can see here the PSD that's done is the one where you do your input. If not, you can just use the Rosen Rambler. And Rosen Rambler is where you guess 2 points on a curve. Often that's all you really need to do. So like the percentage passing at size 25 and the percentage passing 50. Then what you could do is here you can say if it's a wet or a dry screen, the hertz and the amplitude you just do by selecting any of these. And then you can change the aperture size. Let's say make it 12. There you can see the PSD curves changed. And as you can see, you can actually go and actually have a good look at where all these inputs come from, or each one of the calculations. And as I've mentioned, all these factors are in the vibrating screen manufacturer's model. So I hope you enjoy this, and I hope it helps you to have a good, intelligent discussion with the screen supplier should you need to put the correct screen into your plant. So yeah. Thank you very much.